But the first one was an answer to prayer. And the prayer was 18 years ago. And I think some of you here aren't even 18, so it's been a long, long wait. And the Lord promised me four things, and it was about a very, very difficult relationship. And there was times where, and it was very hard because it was a Christian brother, a brother in leadership, a brother who should have, you would have thought, you know. But anyways, pain of the heart and Satan's work can really bind us. If anyone's wounded, please seek the Lord. Do not let your heart be bound. We all get hurt. We all have childhood problems. We all have difficult relationships. Please seek God and get help. Do not let your heart be bound. So anyways, this prayer that the Lord, this promise the Lord gave me 18 years ago, three parts the Lord was going to move in this man's heart. And the fourth part was the answer of he promised rejoicing to my heart. And that has come to pass. And it was very long. 6 years of this person wouldn't even look at me. It was difficult. It was warfare. I remember I needed a 10-year plan to protect my heart. And after the months went by, the days went by, I realized I needed a lifelong plan for my heart. So please, please, if any of you are wounded, please remember this, okay? The second thing, the Lord, even longer than that, the Lord gave me a scripture for someone very dear to me to snatch them out of the fire, and the years have gone by. It's longer than 18 years, and just 2 weeks ago, I remember that the Lord stirred that back to me, scripture, and I said, Lord, I don't know how to do this. I don't know when it's going to happen. It never seemed like an open door, and the very next morning, the door opened wide for that to start. That the Lord just gave us time together. It was like just a spacious place to start to share the word of the Lord with her. And so it's so, so exciting. And but the battle's on there. And the third thing happened this week. I've been really praying for someone's work situation that it's very difficult, and I've been praying that the Lord would cause some of the people there to come under this believer's authority and to really touch the peace of the Lord. And when I was with my folks, going up to my folks' apartment this week, there was a young girl who got into the elevator, and all of a sudden she started to be just consumed with fear and nauseousness and everything, and I was able to help her and stick with her, and we had to leave the elevator, and as we were going up the stairwell instead, I was able to, all of a sudden that came back, that prayer that I've been having about our authority and her, someone touching the peace of the Lord in it, and I'm praying all the way up the stairs with her, and by the time she's out, she's just full of the peace of the Lord and so thankful. So I was really blessed.
Praise the Lord.
Good night, everyone. My name is David. I am from Lambton College. Coming to Canada, this is a scholarship I'm on for 1 year. As in, the government of Canada give us money for the whole entire thing. We don't have to work for money. And this week it was hard because I had an assignment due, and I never knew what to do. And I was like, God, give up. And God was like, no. And the day that the assignment was due, the teacher came in the class and actually did the assignment for me. And I got 100, and I'm like, all right, God, you're doing something weird. But at the end of the day is, if you trust God, the word of God said that things not God start is able to finish it and get to completion. Yep. So even though someone might be going through some stuff, and I have to say something that the Lord has laid upon my heart, that he's about to expand your territory and your borders. You have to be ready for the expansion. And then the scripture came to me that I hear the abundance of rain, and God's about to do something in doing the most that people won't even understand, you guys. But God said he likes the faithfulness that you have towards him. He has done so many things, and the enemy has tried so many things against you. But God is about to move. and be ready for that move.
This week, Tuesday, I was on Facebook, and dear old friends of mine that are in the New Tribe Mission, Mike and Beth Sutton, asked for people to pray because her husband had to emerge and he has malaria. So God led me to pray over on the internet, and next thing a minute I got a message back that they really appreciated it, and so it was something that he led to. And then last night I was at Chris and Steph's socket. They threw me a birthday party, and there was a phone call from somebody that's going through a real hard time with a divorce from the Vineyard one, and it was bad news. And I brought a birthday card there, but she didn't come because of all the upset. So I got a phone back from Steph Socket this morning that she was bawling, and that card that I got for her, for that person's birthday, really touched her. Because I felt really that God spoke to me for this card at the Christian bookstore to give it to her. So just a little praise.
Yeah. Amen. He's out there in the desert and he's baptizing people. And he's saying, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Now this was John's testimony. I'm reading at verse 19. Now this was John's testimony when the Jews of Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to ask him who he was. He did not fail to confess, but confessed freely, I am not the Christ. They asked him, then who are you? Are you Elijah? He said, I am not. Are you a prophet? He answered, no. Finally they said, who are you? Give us an answer to take back to those who sent us. What do you say about yourself? John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, I am the voice of one calling in the desert. Make straight the way for the Lord. Now some Pharisees who had been sent questioned him, why then do you baptize if you are not the Christ, nor Elijah, nor the prophet? I baptize with water, John replied, but among you stands one you do not know. He is the one who comes after me, the thongs of whose sandals I am not worthy to untie. This all happened at Bethany on the other side of Jordan where John was baptizing. The next day, John saw Jesus. So why do you guys do church on Friday night? Mark, why do you go to two churches? Why do you pray? Why do you read the Bible? The next day, John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. That's the Bible. Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world so that you can spend eternity with a Father who loves you. Pastor Pitt, why don't you come up?